Ukraine is a beautiful, beautiful country. It's been behind the Iron Curtain, except for the last 15 years. It was behind the Iron Curtain for 70 years, a time in world history when a lot happened in the world and wasn't happening over there. I mean, in regard to technology and a lot of just cultural things that in the West we're used to. They're now getting to that level, but there's a rich history there. Kiev, the city that I lived in for about 13 years, 1,500 years old. Just amazing things to see and do there. I told the group this morning how we go under the church is called the Pechersk Lavra, right? Pechersk Lavra. And go into the catacombs down there, the tunnels that they built hundreds and hundreds of years ago for the Christians that were hiding, essentially. You go down there and see the dead saints that they pretty much refer to them as the saints because they're the ones whose bodies didn't decompose, and they're still down there in these little boxes, and you can actually look at them. They have glass over them, and sometimes you'll see little hands sticking out from a blanket or something. Interesting. Black or kind of a gray hand sticking out. But amazing, you know, and not only that, but just some of the monuments, just to kind of, in your mind's eye, imagine what it would have been like to see, like, the Mongols, for example, or someone coming across the Dnieper River attacking the city back, and then, you know, the armed or the walled, the walls that encompass the city back then. There's still a section of that in the capital of Kiev you can look at. But it's just really a beautiful, like I say, and a very, very interesting part of the world. And the Orthodox religion is a big part of the culture, and you'll see lots of churches from that denomination, from that tradition. You can taste lots of excellent food. This is a bowl of borscht, which is a traditional Ukrainian food made of beets and cabbage and potatoes and lots of stuff, depending on what the Hizaika wants to put in there, what the hostess wants to put in there. But the food is natural, almost always homemade, just very, very delicious. We eat real well over there. And the time that you'd be there, in late June, there would be the start of the fruit season, the strawberries, the sweet cherries, and maybe some apricots, things like that, but just lots of real delicious food to choose from. Come to Seoul. We believe that the Word of God is like seed, and when we plant it, some will come to fruition. And so we want to sow, and we want to sow a lot. And we want to use whatever giftings that God has put in us, believing that when we preach the Word, it won't come back void. And when we love and serve in the name of Jesus, that that's going to make a difference too. So whether you're a preacher or a teacher or you're someone that can encourage or work with children or pound a nail, wash a dish, it's not important. But what's important is that we do it in the Spirit and that we do it for His glory. Come to serve. And like I say, we can do that by helping to build and or distribute literature, clean, just put an arm around someone, and love. And I think we can all do that pretty well here.